Hi, hello, namaste, welcome to my channel Do Smart Learn Smart. Today we will discuss about problems in power unit system. So what are the steps we have to follow to solve the problems in power unit systems? We will discuss now. So coming to the first step, so we have to assume base value. So here S base we have to assume for the entire system, that is the first step. So second step is here we have to identify the V base value by using from the transformer defined by the transformer and any off nominal tap settings it may have. Based on that we can analyze the V base, and after finding V base, after identifying V base, third step is Z base. Z base is calculated by using S base and V base. Next, after finding the base impedance values, now we have to calculate the new per unit impedance values. Why? Because here in per unit systems, here in this problem we have to calculate the per unit impedance diagram. So further we have to calculate the new per unit impedance values. So how final step is new per unit impedance values calculation. How we'll calculate these new per unit impedance values means converting the old per unit values on old base values to the new ones. So these are the steps we have to follow to calculate the per unit impedance diagram in per unit system. Now coming to the problem, this is a line diagram for the 6 bus power system is given. For this power system we have to draw the per unit impedance diagram. Here in this problem, at the bus 1 generator is connected. So the ratings of generator is given 90 MVA and 22 kV, and the X per unit reactance per unit value is 0.18, and at the receiving end side motor is connected and the motor ratings are also given. So X per unit reactance per unit value is 0.185, and the ratings of the motor is 66.5 MVA and 10.45 kilovolts. These are the ratings of generator and motor. And again, from bus 1 to bus 13 transformer 1 is connected. 3 to 5 in between 3 to 4 line transmission line is connected, and 4 to 2 transformer 2 is connected, and 1 to 5 transformer 3 is connected, and 5 to 6 transmission line is connected, 6 to 2 transformer 4 is connected. So that is at the receiving end side 3 phase load is also connected. So that load ratings are 10.45 kilovolts and absorbs power at 57 MVA at the power factor 0.6 lagging. And the ratings of transformers are also given: transformer 1, transformer 2, transformer 3 and transformer 4. The ratings are also given and per unit values are also given. And coming to the transmission lines, transmission line impedances are also given, 48.4 ohms, and line 2 it will be having 65.43 ohms. These are the given values for the different components connected to the power system. So now we have to draw the per unit diagram for this power system. So based on the given values, first we have to draw the equivalent impedance diagram. So here 4 transformers are given and 2 transmission lines are there, and at the sending end side generator is connected, and the receiving end side motor is connected, and 3 phase load is also connected. So based on that we have to draw the equivalent impedance diagram. So at the generator side it will be having internal EMF and internal per unit reactance. Same manner we have to represent motor equivalent circuit also. So for motor it will be having internal EMF and it will be having reactance. So at the sending end side we have to represent EZ, generator EMF and generator reactance. In the same manner, receiving end side motor EMF, motor reactance. Now coming to the sending end to receiving end side, so how many elements are connected? Transformer 1, XT1, and that is connected to transmission line 1, and that is connected to transmission line 2. So these are having reactances. So XT1, we have to represent XT1, XL1, XT2. And same manner for transformer 2, line 2, transformer 4, reactance will be represented by XT3, XL2, XT4. And here at the receiving end side, three-phase load is also connected. Further, it will be having reactance and resistance R1 and X1. These are by using these elements we have to represent the equivalent impedance diagram. To obtain new normalized per unit impedance values, first we have to figure out the base values, that are S base, V base, Z base. So coming to the first step, so what is the first step? Assume system base. So first step is assume a system base. So how we will assume the system base? So based on the system wide, S base will be, take it as 100 MVA. So this is a random assumption. So that is chosen to make the calculations easy. So when calculating the per unit values, we have to choose, this is a random assumption we have to take, S base is taken as 100 MVA. That is the first step we have to follow. Now coming to the second step. So in second step, we have to identify the voltage basis. So base values of voltages. So further, we have to divide the line diagram based on the given transformers. So here I taken this line diagram into three sections based on the transformers given. So from the transformer T1 and T3 primary side up to the primary side, we will take it as a session one, and up to secondary side to the next transformers primary side, we have to take the session two, and after that the totals will be taken as a session three. Like that we have to divide the line diagram. Now coming to the base values, how we will calculate the base values? For example, here for transformer, the ratings is given as 22 kV by 220 kV, that is primary side is 22 kV and secondary side is 220 kV. So V base on primary side we have to take 22 kV, and V base on secondary side we have to take 220 kV. So for that I represented V base 1. So for T1, primary side value is 22 kV. Next, coming to the secondary side, it is 220. And again T2 primary side is also given as 220 kV. So that's why we have to take the V base 2 is 220 kV. Okay, next coming to the transformer 3. Transformer 3 primary side is 22 kV. Okay, already we are represented here 22 kV. And coming to this this one, this session, this side, transformer 3 secondary side, it will be 110 kV. So now we have to take the V base 3 as 110 kV. Now coming to the transformer 4, transformer 4 ratings are primary side is 110 kV and secondary side is 11 kV. Okay, so here already we are represented primary side value. So now secondary side is 11 kV, that we have to take the V base 4 as 11 kV. Like that, based on the given transformer ratings, we have to identify the voltage basis. Okay, that is the second step. Now coming to the third step. So in third step, we have to calculate the base impedance values. So what is the formula for calculation of base impedance? Z base equals to KV square base by S base. So this is the formula for finding impedance base value. So here, which elements are having these impedances? Actually, for this circuit diagram, transmission line 1, transmission line 2, and three phase load, these three components will be having impedance values. So for these three components, we have to calculate the impedance values, that is for transmission line 1, for transmission line 2, and for three phase load. we have to calculate the base impedances. Now for transmission line 1, Z base will be calculated as, so the formula is KV base square by S base. So for transmission line 1, what is the base value? For transmission line 1, that is session 2, V base 2 is 220. So now we have to take, for transmission line 1, V base is 220 kV whole square divided by S base is, already we are assumed in the step 1, that is S base is 100 MVA. So from this we have to calculate the Z base value. So that means after simplifying we'll get 484 ohms. So this is the base impedance for transmission line 1. Same manner for transmission line 2 and for 3-phase load also we have to calculate the base impedances. Now for transmission line 2, Z base value is by using formula KV base square by S base. So for transmission line 2, it will be having V base 3. So V base 3 is, we are identified that value, that is 110 KV. Substitute that value in this formula, then we will get Z base value for transmission line 2. Similarly, we can calculate the Z base value for 3-phase load. So for 3-phase load, KV base value will be taken as V base 4 is 11 KV. So substitute that value in this, then 11 square by 100. S base value is 100 MVA. Substitute these values, then we will get the impedance, base impedances for transmission line 2 and 3-phase load. Now coming to the fourth step, calculate the per unit impedance values. So for calculating per unit impedance values, by using formula, Z per unit equals to actual impedance by base value. So actual by base. So by using this, we can calculate the Z per unit nu. So already also we know the equation for nu Z per unit. So the equation for nu per unit value is equals to Z per unit old into S base nu by S base old into V base old by V base nu whole square. By using this formula, we can calculate the new per unit impedance values. So what are the elements we are having? Transmission line 1, transmission line 2 and 3-phase loads. We have to calculate the per unit values by using actual values. So here for transmission line 1, already total value is given, actual value is given. By using that values, we can calculate the per unit value. For transmission line 2, it is given as 65.43. And for transmission line 2, we are calculated in the by using formula that is 121.0 ohms. Now substitute that value in this formula, then we will get the per unit value for transmission line 2. And similarly for 3-phase load, so actual power factor is equal, cos phi is nothing but power factor. So here why we are calculating power factor means, here in the problem power factor is also mentioned. So that's why power factor is equals to cos inverse of angle, that is 0.6 lag is given. So based on that, the angle is power factor is at an angle 53.13 we'll get. So 3-phase load. Now coming to the 3-phase load, already 57 MVA is given. So magnitude at an angle, here we are represented 3-phase load, that is S 3-phase load is equals to 57 at an angle 53.13. After finding 3-phase load MVA, so here the actual impedance will be calculated for the 3-phase load is KV square base by S base. So that is, already for 3-phase load KV rating is given, that is 10.45. Substitute that value in this, and S base is also calculated above, and the power factor is lagging power factor, that's why here we are represented minus 53.13. and after simplifying this equation, we will get the Z actual for 3-phase load. So simplifying this equation, we will get actual value of impedance for three phase load. After calculating actual value, coming to the per unit value of the impedance. So per unit value will be calculated by the formula actual by base value. So here in above equation we are calculated actual value, and in previous say third step we are calculated base value. Substitute that value of the three phase load here, then simplifying this equation we'll automatically get the value for Z per unit for three phase. Now coming to the new per unit reactance calculations. For generator we can represent XSG. So what is the formula for new per unit values? Old value into V base new whole square into S base new by S base old. So by using that formula, so this is the formula we are used. New values is equals to old values Z per unit old into S base new by S base old into V base old by V base new whole square. So by using this formula we can easily calculate the per unit values of generator. So for generator, old value is reactance old value is given in problem 0.18, and S base new value is 100 and S base old value is 90. So that is given in problem, and V base old value is 22, V base new value is 22 whole square. Then we can easily calculate the reactance per unit for generator. Similarly, we can calculate the transformer 1, transformer 2. So this is for transformer 1 calculation, this is for transformer 2, and this is for transformer 3, and also transformer 4. So next, at the receiving end side we are having a motor also. For motor having reactance, so per unit reactance that will be calculated like this. So by using these all quantities of new per units, now we have to draw the per unit diagram, per unit reactance diagram or per unit impedance diagram. So that is the final solution for this problem. Now draw the per unit reactance diagram. So for generator it will be having per unit reactance that we are calculated, and also for transformer 1, transformer 2, transformer 3 and transformer 4, and for transmission line 1, transmission line 2, and for motor reactance and for three phase reactances we are all calculated above. So substituting all the values here, finally we will draw the per unit impedance diagram. So this is the final answer for the problem. Thank you.